Time to begin with the talk today. Our speaker is Ruya Uster from Istanbul University in Turkey. And she's going to talk about projectivity and injectivity of auric spaces. Ruya, whenever you want.
Thank you very much. First of all, I would like to thank Professor Blasco and the organizers for their kind invitation, and I am very happy to join these seminars. Today, I am going to talk about some homological properties for OLED space, such as projectivity, injectivity, and flatness. And this is a joint work with Professor Öztop. Before starting my talk, I would like to mention some historical developments for the OLED space. Ever since the Lebesgue integration theory has taken center stage in analysis, a more inclusive class of space is naturally needed, and this could be seen in the 1915s with the publication of Delavalle Poisson. Indeed, his research was Banach research, but formally gave birth of OLED space. OLED space first proposed by Birnbaum and Ohrlich, and after developed by Ohrlich himself, and in 1961, a monograph by Krasnoselsky and Rutecki, used effectively in different branches of mathematics and statistics. For example, integral equations, differential equations, statistics, and probability, and of course, harmonic analysis as well. And in 1991, a more inclusive research is made by Rho and Ren. In this talk, first, I will define Ohrlich space, and I will mention some properties of Ohrlich space. I will give some homological properties and preliminary results, and in the end, I will state our main theorems. Actually, Ohrlich space is a generalization of classical Lebesgue spaces, and with this generalization, the function x up to power p replaced by a more general convex function phi, and later on we will call this Young function. Besides the Lebesgue spaces, a variety of function spaces containing Ohrlich space, for example, L logarithm L Hardy-Littlewood maximal spaces, also Ohrlich space contains certain Sobolev spaces, S subspace, and the linear properties for Ohrlich space have been studied by many mathematicians. Very recently, the Ohrlich space and the weighted Ohrlich spaces are considered as Banach algebras over a locally compact group. But a little attention has been paid its model structure. In this talk, our goal is study possible model structure for the Ohrlich space. For defining the Ohrlich space, our main tool is Young function. A function, a non-zero function phi from 0 infinity into extended real numbers is called a Young function if phi satisfies these three conditions. For any given Young function phi, its complementary pair is defined by the following equality. And by definition, psi is also a Young function. And again, by definition of Young function, it can be discontinuous at such a point. For our research, we will suppose that both phi and psi are continuous and strictly increasing. Now we can define our space. Let G be a locally compact group and phi be a Young function. Then the Ohrlich space L phi G is defined in the equality 2. And here mu is left Hauer measure on the locally compact group G, and F indicates the mu equivalent class of measurable functions. There are two equivalent norms on Ohlich space. The first one is Ohlich norm, and here phi and psi are complementary functions, and nu in Lp psi g. Also, the supremum is taken over the unit ball of Lp psi g. And the second one is Luxembourg norm, sometimes it's called Gauge norm. And Ohlich space is a Banach space with respect to these two norms. Let us give some examples for the complementary Young pairs and for the concrete local compact groups. If we take the Young function x, then its complementary is 0 if y is between 0 and 1, and otherwise infinity. And in this case, Lg is L1g, and Lp psi g becomes L infinity g. At the beginning, we said that Ohlich space is a generalization of classical Lebesgue spaces. So if we take our Young function x up the power p over p, and here p and q are between 1 and infinity, and p and q are conjugate numbers, then its complementary pair is given by y up the power q over q, and this time Lφg becomes the classical Lebesgue space Lpg, and Lp psi g becomes Lqg. Another example is given by with this exponential function, and this time its complementary function given by logarithm function. I want to give some locally compact group examples because in the end our results will depend on the compactness of the group, so it's useful to give here. The multiplicative group R star is non-compact locally compact group, and its R measure is given by dx over modulus x, and here dx denotes the Lebesgue measure. The multiplicative group C star is also non-compact locally compact group, and its R measure is given by this formula. Rn is another non-compact locally compact group example, and the Lebesgue measure on Rn is the R measure. The general linear groups is another non-compact locally compact groups, and its R measure is given by this formula, and dA is the Lebesgue measure on a matrix space. The special unitary groups are compact groups, and if f is any integrable function on SU2, then its integral with respect to the R measure is given by the following equality. Also, the special orthogonal groups are another compact group example. And again, if f is integrable with respect to the R measure, then the integral of f is given by this equality. For any two Young functions, it is said to be strongly equivalent if there exist positive constants a and b with this inequality. And by definition, strongly equivalent Young functions generate the same Ohlich space. For example, if we take our Young function x ln 1 plus x, then its complementary function p psi is strongly equivalent cosine h of x minus 1 and vice versa. Also, if we take the Young function x logarithm x, in this time Ohlich space is the Zygmund space L logarithm L, and if we take the Young function, this exponential function, then the Ohlich space L phi is the exponential Zygmund space. For Ohlich space theory, one of the important properties is delta 2 condition. A young function phi is said to satisfy delta 2 condition if there exist constants, positive constants, k and x0, such that the inequality 4 holds. If we take our young function x to the p over p, it satisfies delta 2 condition, but in this second example, this exponential function does not satisfy delta 2 condition. Delta 2 condition is important for us because if the young function satisfies delta 2 condition, then the continuous compactly supported space CC, if you take on a locally compact group G, is dense in alpha G. Also, if both psi and psi, the complementary pair, both satisfy delta 2 condition, then the Euler space becomes reflexive space. Now, I will give some homological properties. Let A be a Banach algebra and E be a left or right Banach A module. We will use A module for the categories of left Banach A modules and mod A for the categories of right Banach A modules. We can think the algebras, Banach algebras, in three different categories. The first one is function algebras. For example, if we take A, the complex numbers, so with the pointwise multiplication and the module, it's a commutative unital Banach algebra. Also, if we take C0x, and here x is locally compact Hausdorff space, f is continuous and vanish at infinity, then again with the pointwise product and with the supremum norm, A is commutative Banach algebra and A is unital if and only if this space is compact. The second category is operator algebras. Let X be any linear space and Y be a Banach space. Then the bounded linear operator space is a Banach algebra with the composition multiplication and with the operator norm. It's not commutative, but it is unital. Also, the third category of algebra is group algebra. If we take L1G with the convolution multiplication and with the L1 norm, it's a Banach algebra. If G is commutative group, then A is commutative Banach algebra. But L1G does not have a unit. It has bounded approximate identity. Also, if we take little L1Z, it is the unital commutative Banach algebra with the discrete convolution product and with the little L1 norm. And let us give some module examples. If we take continuous function space between 0 and 1, it's a Banach algebra. And if we take E as L2, 0 and 1, it is A bi module. It's left module and right module. Also, C0G is left Banach A module, L1G module in here. The measure algebra on locally compact group G, it's again algebra, it's left and right A module. For any two Banach spaces E and F, and for any bounded linear operator from E to F, T is called admissible if there exists bounded linear operator from F to E such that their composition is identity. Now we can give our first main definition. Let P be a left Banach A module. Then P is called projective if for E and F left Banach A modules, for each epimorphism T from E to F, and here T is onto, and for each morphism from P to F, There exists R from P to E with this property. And here ABEF is closed linear subspace of BEF with all the A module morphisms. And this diagram commutes. We can define the injective module. Let J be a left Banach A module. And for each admissible monomorphism, T is here one to one. And for each morphism S from E to J, there exists R with this property. Again, this diagram commutes. The definition of the flatness depends on the definition of the injective module. The A flat module if the dual of E is injective in right Banach A module, and the module action is given by the this equality. Also, all these definitions apply for the right Banach A modules or Banach bimodules. In the end, also our results depend on the amenability of the group. So here I want to give the definition of amenability. Let G be a locally compact group and E be a subspace of L infinity G consisting the constant functions. Then a mean on E is a bounded linear functional with this property, and the group G is said to be amenable if there exists a left invariant mean on L infinity G. Here, left invariant means, I'm sorry for my writing, LXF M is FM. And here, LX is translation operator and F in the E. Let us give some projective, injective, and flat A modules. If we take our Banach algebra L1Z with the convolution multiplication, then we know that every Banach algebra is a bimodule on itself. And here L1Z is projective and injective left Banach A modules. For the Banach algebra C01 and for the A module L201, E is injective and flat A module, but it's not projective. Also, if we take any non-compact, locally compact group, and if we take our Banach algebra L1G and the A module is C0G, E is not projective and it's not injective left Banach A module, and E is flat if and only if the group is amenable. Another example depends on the amenability of the group. If G is amenable non-discrete local compact group, then M of G is injective and flat L1G module, but it's not projective. Again, let A be a Banach algebra and E be a left Banach A module. E is called essential if AE is dense in E, and here AE is the linear span of this set. If A has bounded approximate identity, then we can take AE with this set. For any locally compact group G and for any Young function phi, all its space is essential L1G module with respect to convolution product. Let T be bounded linear operator from E to F and T satisfies the A module morphism. Then we call T retraction if there exists bounded linear operator from F to E, and moreover S satisfies left A module morphism with this property. Now we can give one of the most important proposition for us. If E is any essential left Banach A module, then E is projective if and only if the canonical morphism from a projective tensor product E to E is a retraction. And also, if E is projective and one of the Banach spaces A or E has the approximation property, then for each non-negative element in E, there exists bounded linear left A module morphism T with this property. This proposition for the projectivity, because we define projectivity and there are a lot of properties in the definition, but with this proposition, it depends on the projectivity of E, depends on the retraction module. Now we can give our first result. For the locally compact group G and the Young function phi with the delta 2 condition, phi G is projective left Banach L1G module if and only if the group G is compact. I want to give this sketch of the proof. First, suppose that G is compact, and by using the previous proposition, we need to determine the canonical morphism pi from L1G projective product, L phi G to L phi G is a retraction. Since G is compact, its higher measure is 1. Also, we know that for any Banach space X, its projective tensor product with L1G isometric isomorph the second space. Let us define our function, our morphism rho, with the equality 6, and it can be shown that rho is bounded linear and satisfies left morphism. Also, the composition of rho and pi is identity, so pi is a retraction, and this means phi g is projective left Banach L1G module. Also, it's again applies the right Banach L1G module. For the converse part, it's much more technical. Let phi g projective L1G module, and suppose on the contrary that g is not compact. Let V and omega compact symmetric neighborhood of identity element E of G with this property. So there exists continuous compactly supported function F with these properties. Then the convolution F is non-zero and the support of F convolution F is contained in V. Also, since L1G has the approximation property and L5G is essential left Banach L1G module, from the previous proposition, there exists bounded linear operator T with this property. Now set eta with this function and fix K. Since G is not compact, there exist finite elements in G such that these sets are pairwise disjoint. And if we take fjx with the translation of sj, and if we take lambda with this function, since s1v, s2v, and skv are pairwise disjoint, this norm is 1. Also, from the previous steps, we can get this inequality. But at the beginning, we said our eta is this function. And here, if we take, if we put the k the other other side, this is the required contradiction. So G must be compact. In this theorem, we see that the projectivity of the L1G module L5G depends on the compactness of the group. For example, at the first we give some example. For example, SU2 is compact local compact group. So if we take alpha SU2, since SU2 is Compact group L5SU2 is projective L1SU2 model. For the if part, also we can use the following result. If there exists projective essential left Banach L1G modules with the dual of X being either norm separable or weakly sequentially complete, then G is compact. So we can give the following observation. If G is an local compact group and phi and psi complementary pair with both phi and psi satisfy delta 2 condition, then if alpha G is projective module and G is separable, then the group is compact. For injectivity and flatness, we need this theorem. Every right or left module over an amenable Banach algebra is flat, and moreover, every dual module is injective. Also, there is a connection between the amenability of the group and the amenability of the Banach algebra. If G is any locally compact group, then the amenability of group implies amenability of L1G and vice versa. So we can give the following results. For the Young function phi, if the group G is amenable, then the Euler space is flat left Banach L1G module. The dual module of alpha G is injective in right Banach L1G module. And if phi and psi both satisfy delta 2 condition, Euler space is both injective and flat L1G module. And here, the injectiveness and flatness of the Euler space depends on the amenability of the underlying group. Again, we can if we take our G is abelian group or finite group or compact group, then alpha G is injective and again flatness. For example, the F2 is non-amenable group. So alpha F2 is not injective and it's not a flat group. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Ruya, for your talk. Now it's the time for some questions or comments. Do we have questions or comments? No. So in this case, we thank again to Ruya for her nice talk.